News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Dr. John Scala.
A good place to start with the forecast is to look at what's happening, diagnose the current situation, and then let the models begin to tell us how this may evolve. So let's begin that way. The Arctic boundary has gone through Buffalo, through Rochester, New York, and actually just moving through Erie, Pennsylvania. Much colder air situated over Ontario and now moving into Quebec. And as we look across the upper Midwest, there is a disturbance now that's in the mid-levels of the atmosphere crossing South Dakota. And that's going to meet up with our front down over the Carolinas. That will be the coastal storm. Now, how this plays out, that's what the models are helping us decipher. And we're still not exactly sure. So as we talked about some of the snowfall totals, that's our first look that may have to be modified. But as we look across the region, you can see the cloud cover is thickening up ahead of the front. And these numbers are very close to today's high temperatures. 36 right now in Harrisburg, 43 at Thomasville in York County. Gettysburg coming in at 43 in Adams County. So we're expecting to see the clouds continue to thicken. As you can see live, looking over the city of York, that cloud base is beginning to lower just a little bit where the temperature is 43. Feels a little bit like 38 due to that southwesterly flow. So it's going to be a little on the chilly side, despite the fact that these numbers are at or above average temperatures for this time of the year. So the forecast, thickening clouds, will turn breezy as that front approaches. We expect that front to come through probably around 5 to 8 p.m. this evening. Our temperatures, about where they are right now, will be today's highs. These clouds will lower through the overnight hours, much colder as the Arctic front sags to the south. So look for wind chills by tomorrow morning in the single digits. Our temperature is upper teens to only 20, and that is the high temperature tomorrow. It's tomorrow morning's temperatures will be the daytime highs. The snow will spread from the southwest and move east across the valley. As I said earlier, the heaviest will be south of the PA Turnpike and I-81, and it will continue through the daytime hours as our temperatures fall through the teens and into the single digits by Wednesday morning. Here's the Arctic air mass working its way across. Saranac Lake is 10, Toronto 14, North Bay is negative 11 at this point. So we'll show you what the satellite and the radar connection looks like at this point. There's our boundary. It's got some snow with it across upstate New York. It's likely to dry out, though, as it heads further to the south. So at this point, not expecting the frontal passage to be accompanied by anything other than the cloudiness and maybe a flurry or two. The model underdoing the cloud cover, obviously, but it will be here through the overnight and into tomorrow. Now watch how this model begins to stream in the snow from the southwest tomorrow morning, and it produces the heaviest bands south of Route 30 and south of the PA Turnpike. I think it may be underdoing it a little too far south, but certainly the heaviest will be across northern Maryland, Delmarva, and into southern New Jersey, where 8 to 12 inches of snow are possible. It leaves the scene and gives us a bitterly cold day on Wednesday. Wind chills below zero to start your day on Wednesday. High temperatures only getting up towards the teens. And we're looking at a very cold period ahead. And to round out this discussion, Susan, let's once again show you what we're thinking in terms of our snow totals. And this is our first look right now at the heaviest amounts, obviously closer to the Maryland state line. And Harrisburg may be the tricky point here because it could be less than 4 or more than 4. But certainly this is going to be an accumulating event.
So it's going to be location, location, location.
As it always
right.
is.
Exactly. All right. Thank you, John.